Hi guys, this video is a revised edition of an earlier video I made showing what SKSE was and how to install it. Now, the reason I'm releasing this video is the Skyrim 1.6 patch has been released, and the latest version of SKSE that is needed for that is a little different to the previous version of SKSE. In fact, it's actually a little different to all previous script extenders, and there is just a few more steps in installing the mod. And the reason for this is that they have now added support for the Papyrus script engine. That's the script engine that the game uses. And this is really going to increase the number of mods and, more importantly, the type of mods we're going to get. It's really opened several doors, including things like the ability to detect which key is being pressed. But I'm not going to go into great detail about that because this is not a video aimed at mod authors. This video is aimed at people who are fairly new to modding. So if you've installed a few mods and you've come across a mod that you really would like to try, but it requires SKSE and you're not sure what that is, or you're a little nervous about installing it, this video is for you. So what is SKSE? Well, it's basically a modder's resource that expands the scripting capabilities of the game and essentially lets mod authors create mods that can do things that would otherwise be impossible. You have to understand that the creation kit does not give you absolute power to create whatever mod you like. There are a lot of limitations, and SKSE attempts to get past those limitations. And we're talking about fairly basic things like detecting key presses the player makes or sending information to the user interface. If you look at some of the mods made for Oblivion, like the minimap, or for New Vegas and Fallout, anything that detected a key press, anything that added new elements to the user interface and then manipulated them in-game, updated them from in-game, they all required script extender, and Skyrim is not going to be any different. Now, it's perfectly reasonable to be somewhat nervous or reluctant to run your game via a third-party piece of software that was not shipped by the developer. I completely understand that, and in fact, I actually encourage that type of attitude. You should always find out what it is you are running. So feel free to ask around, Google, etc. And if you just check out the sheer volume of mods that use them, you'll see that really these things are pretty well accepted. They're seen as normal in the general modding community now. So how does it affect performance? Well, it really doesn't affect performance at all by itself. Obviously, SKSE mods themselves affect performance just like any mod does, but they won't affect the performance any more than normal mods. In fact, several things in SKSE may well actually make it possible to make mods perform better. There are also cases where we've had several mods that have been released that actually improve game performance. That's the entire point of the mod. Okay, so let's install SKSE. Now, obviously, the first thing we need to do is download it. And you will find it at skse.silverlock.org. Now, the build I'm downloading is the 1.5.9 build, and it is compatible with the 1.6 version of Skyrim. So I'm going to simply right-click and save link as, and then I'm going to save mine to the desktop. You can place yours wherever you like, but I like to work on my desktop. Now, once it has downloaded, you will have a single archive, and it is a 7z file. 7z is a type of archive. It's like zip or rar. You can extract these type of files with a program such as WinRAR or 7zip, and I will link to those programs down below. And the first thing I'm going to do is extract this archive, right here. Now I'm going to use WinRAR and I'm just going to do extract here. So basically let's get rid of this. I right click on the file, extract here, and it will immediately start extracting and I will have a folder. I can now delete the archive. Don't need the archive anymore. Okay, so we will open this folder up and inside it you will find some files all beginning with SKSE. And you will find a data folder and an SRC folder. The SRC folder is the source code for SKSE, so you can check it out if you wish. But we will be ignoring it. You do not need that folder. You're going to need your Skyrim folder. That is the folder where your Skyrim game is installed. Now for me, it's in Games, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, Skyrim. But I have an F drive called Games and it's just for my games. The default location for this is usually C program files, something like that. So it'd be C program files, Steam, Steam Apps, Common, and Skyrim. You'll know if you've got the right place. Basically, you're looking for tesv.exe, the Elder Scrolls 5.executable. If you can't find that, if you just find a file called TESV with no extension, it probably means that you have known extensions hidden. You can actually turn that off, and I would actually. You go to Tools, Folder Options, View, and you'll probably find you've got something like Hide Extensions for Known File Types, and if I apply that, and then go and look at this folder. Oh, it won't let me, excuse me. And go and look at this folder. You will notice that my Elder Scrolls executable, the tesv.exe, has lost its .exe. So if you've got that file, it's probably the correct one. However, folder options again, view. I don't want to hide extensions for known file types. It's actually very useful to be able to see the file extensions. I'm sorry if you knew that already, but I thought I'd make sure I cover that because sometimes I get questions where people actually say, I cannot find the tesv.exe, but I can find TESV. That's probably the correct folder. So, to install SKSE, you start by selecting from the folder you downloaded, from the folder you extracted from the archive, select all of the files beginning with SKSE, right-click, and copy, or control C if you prefer that, then right click and paste into your Skyrim folder, and then you're going to copy and replace. So just do this for the next six conflicts, copy and replace. That's if you've already got a version of SKSE installed. If you don't have a version of SKSE installed, you won't get this message. And as you can see, it's copied those files. Now, previously, that's all there was to installing SKSE, but that is not the case anymore. As I mentioned, SKSE now has support for the Papyrus script engine, but the Skyrim game stores its scripts as resources, very similar to meshes and textures, and so now you will notice the data folder. Now, when you look at the SKSE readme text, it gives you the installation instructions, and it does in fact tell you to copy the contents of the data folder into your SKSE directory, and you can do this. You can actually just right click, copy, and then paste it here. It will say to you, do you wish to overwrite your data folder? And it may even ask, do you wish to overwrite your scripts folder? And you just click yes every time. However, I prefer to do any files that go in the data folder using a mod manager. The reason for this is just in case you want to uninstall it, then it's a lot easier and it's a lot safer to use a mod manager. So that is what I'm going to do. That's up to you if you want to do the same. You could just copy the data folder in here and overwrite everything, and that will work. But what I'm going to do is I'm going to add to archive. I'm going to use WinRAR again. So I right-click to the data folder. I'll show you again. I right-click the data folder. I add to archive using WinRAR. And then I'm going to rename the bit that says data, and I'm going to call it SKSE scripts. And you can leave everything else the same, and I click OK. I now have the SKSE scripts RAR. I'm going to drag that out and place it on my desktop so it's a little easier to find. So I have SKSE scripts, and I'm going to open the Nexus Mod Manager, go along to the Mods tab, click the Add Mod from File, and then I'm going to select the SKSE scripts.rar. It's now added that as a mod, as if I downloaded it from Nexus, and then I select it and then activate. It's telling me it's already found a script that's been installed. Either it's something I have compiled, which is more than possible because I do quite a lot of work on these scripts. It could be a file installed by a previous mod, although usually Nexus Mod Manager tells you. But this, as you can see, is one of the advantages to doing it via the Mod Manager. You get these checks, and if I uninstall it, it's going to put race.psc back where it belongs. So I'm just going to click yes to all. And that's it. The scripts for SKSE are now installed. If I go along to my data folder, scripts, and if I do date modified, these are all the script files that have just been installed by the script by Nexus Mod Manager for SKSE. So I now have SKSE completely installed. So now we've got it installed, you also have to start running the game from the SKSE launcher. You're probably used to clicking on an icon that says The Elder Scrolls, and you get this nice little launcher appears where you can change your options and or play the game. You cannot run the game this way and have SKSE running. So I only use this when I want to change the options. So I'm going to exit this. From now on, to run the game, I have to run it from the skseloader.exe. Don't worry, it's perfectly safe. And in actual fact, you'll start your game a little bit faster, because instead of waiting for the launcher to appear and then hitting play, you just click on this and off you go. Now I recommend going, I'll show you again, right click, send to, and desktop, create shortcut. I recommend making a shortcut for this. So it's now placed this on my desktop. There it is. Let me just minimize that. And I'm going to put that there. A lot of people don't like the way I lay my desktop out. There are reasons for it, and I may explain one day. Anyway, I'm going to rename it, first of all, to SKSE, so I know that I'm running SKSE from here. I also don't like this icon, so I'm going to go to Properties, Change Icon, and click OK. That's perfectly fine. I then need to find a place where there's a decent icon. The default ones tend to not be very good, so I'm going to click Browse. And for me, it defaults to my Steam Games folder, where there are lots of icons. For you, again, if you go to Games, wherever you've got your Steam installed, Steam, and then Games, you'll probably find a lot of icons like this. And then you can pick one. I'm going to pick, obviously, the Skyrim logo. I then click Apply, and OK. And so now you have your icon, and to run the game, you are simply going to double-click. You'll get a small dark black window appear very briefly as the SKSE launcher starts up, and then it will start the game for you. Once in game, I recommend that the first thing you do is to check that SKSE is running. Just the first time you start the game with SKSE, check it's running. And to do that, the simplest way is to use the console. Now, the console is opened by using the tilde key on a normal American keyboard. It's the key to the left of the one key. Now, international keyboards are different, but the key you're going to press is still the key that is to the left of the one. I believe that is the console key for every keyboard. So if you press the button to the left of the one key, you should see down in the bottom left corner a little line appear, and you get a sort of vague shadow. This is your console area. You can now type in get SKSE version. I don't think the capitalization is important, but you should not have any spaces. Then press the return key, the enter key, and you will get a report as to what SKSE version you have. If it doesn't say that, if it tells you something like an unknown command, you are not running the game in SKSE mode. Now, you don't have to do this to run the game. You do not have to. This is just a good way to check that SKSE is running. I never do this when I start the game. I'm just doing this now to show you how you can tell SKSE is running. Then press the same key, the key to the left of the one, and it will close the console. And that's it. I have the game now running with SKSE running as well. So any mods that require SKSE will now function as intended. And that's it. So from now on, to run your game, you just double click that icon, the SKSE icon, and you will get straight into game. Now, if for some reason you decide to uninstall this mod and to uninstall SKSE, you simply go along to the mod manager and deactivate. That will uninstall the scripts. If you haven't used the mod manager, you're going to have to go into the script folder and find all the scripts that you installed and all the source files that you installed. And if you actually look in here, there's a few of them. There's quite a few. So you will need to find out all the names of all of these and all the names of all these and delete them yourself. So that is why I recommend using the Nexus Mod Manager. And you will also need to go along to your Skyrim game folder and basically uninstall any files beginning with SKSE. Any files beginning with SKSE, delete those, and you will have uninstalled SKSE completely. And then just run your game normally. It's very, very easy, and it will have absolutely no effect on your game once you've uninstalled it. Okay, well, that's it for this video. I hope it was helpful, and I hope you guys will join me in giving a big thanks to the SKSE team. They've put thousands of hours in total in the various script extenders they've made for our games, and I, for one, really appreciate it. The games would just not be the same without their hard work. So thanks a lot, guys. And to the rest of you, I'll see you next time, and until then, have fun.